हेलो गाइस, रिसेंटली कंक्लूडेड एप्पल WWDC 2021 इवेंट कंक्लूडेड व्हेन एप्पल अनाउंस्ड अ मेजर अपडेट्स रिगार्डिंग देयर ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम्स. सो दे अनाउंस्ड iOS 15 फॉर देयर आईफोन्स एंड ऑल्सो दे अनाउंस्ड iWatch 8 फॉर देयर एप्पल वॉचेस. एट द सेम टाइम दे ऑल्सो अनाउंस्ड देयर मैक OS ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम विच विल बी Monterey. So here in this video, we are going to talk about what are its features and what will it impact the Mac OS. So without further ado, let's start with the video. And if you are new to my channel, please subscribe and like my other videos. So here we go again. Actually, we are going to for a walkthrough in Apple's official website because I want to provide you authentic data and I want to give you proof so that whatever I am telling you has some backing from the Apple. So whatever instructions and information that I provide in my channel is actually from the authentic source when I do not make up my videos. So here are macOS Monterey preview. So basically it is the next generation operating system for Macs, and right now we have macOS Big Sur, which is frankly very good and it has a lot of features, but still Apple is the one who pushes their boundaries and introduces new features over the time. So their tagline for this year is high powered meets high everyone. So basically in this macOS Monterey, Apple is focusing on connect, share and create like never before. So basically they are improving their software, improving their operating system, improving their user interface, and also it will make many improvements in the apps that we regularly use, and it will explore a redesigned and streamlined Safari. Also, it will discover and invent powerful new ways to work using universal control and shortcuts. Universal control is very cool feature. I have already discussed in my previous video where I discussed WWDC 2021 event. So please do check out this video guys. Also, it is going to come this fall, so it will be released soon. So what are the features we'll talk about in this video? And basically Apple focuses on new experiences and true connections. So it is staying in touch is more essential than ever since in pandemic times many people had resorted to stay indoors, and at the same time they couldn't be with touch with their loved ones and their office colleagues and all other people. So in this Apple have done wonders and they have made it really easy. So even if you are staying indoor, you will be able to connect with your people like never before. So first of all, there is share play. So what it means that you can watch together, listen together and share your screen right inside FaceTime. So whenever you are making FaceTime calls, so you can actually not only share your live video, but also whatever thing that you are watching on your screen can also be shared with the other whom you are on call. So it also sounds and feel more natural, and messages makes it even easier to find and enjoy the great content shared from friends and family. So let's talk about FaceTime and what is the share play. So keep FaceTime conversation going on as you watch TV shows and movies. So basically whatever you are doing, you will be able to share with your friends over FaceTime. So let's say you are watching some movie and you can actually share that thing with your friends, so it will be synchronized. So both will see the same thing at the same time, so you both will be able to, or whoever on the call will be able to enjoy the content, and it is like doing the stuff together. So online you will hang out, so it's just like hanging out and chilling out with your friends and family. Also if you are on a business call, it will make things much easier. So stream movies and TV shows while on a FaceTime call with friends. So it supports synced playback and controls, and you will see everyone laugh, jump and react at the same moments at the same time, and the volume automatically adjusts so you can keep talking while you watch. So this is going to be very important feature because not only being on a call will be important, but you can also share your things with, so you will have no excuses to not be on the call. So this is going to be a very cool feature because chilling out with friends will mean a different meaning altogether. And listen together, so you can also listen together in this thing. So you can listen to any album with friends and whole group can see what's next and add songs to a shared queue, and sync to playback and easy to use controls. So this is like if you are chilling with friends, you want to spend time with your friends and family, over long distance. It's going to be a really cool feature and I'm really looking forward to it. So also you can share your screen. So while you are on a call or you are having some collaborations with coworkers, or maybe you are having a game night with friends or plan your next vacation as a group, so you can actually share your screen so everyone will be able to see the same thing. Let's assume you are going to take some vacation plan and you want to book some hotels and plan your trip. So on while sharing the screen, you will be able to see everything at the same time, so everyone will come out with their views and you can get discussion like never before. Also, it supports spatial audio. So let's say there are 4 to 5 people are on a call, and when you will be able to precisely hear the voice from where it is happening. So basically the sound will be coming from the direction in which each person is positioned on your screen. So it will be help you conversation flow more naturally. So it will be more important because you won't get confused when many people are on a call. So you will be able to listen to everyone more clearly. Also, they have many mic modes. So voice isolation minimizes background noise and puts your voice front and center. And when the music or sound around you are as important, and when you have to say, wide spectrum leaves the ambient sound unfiltered. So while doing stuff, whenever you speak, everything will be clear for other people. So you won't be muted out and your voice will reach out to the people who are in the front. So it also supports grid view. It has portrait mode, so the focus will be on you and background distractions will be less. So you can completely focus on your call while doing office work, and you won't have to worry about what is happening in the background, and no, neither the other one people. So going to be a really cool feature. So it also have FaceTime links, so you can customize your links, you can send it to your friends, and whether they are on Windows phone or Android phone, they will be able to join the conversation. So this will be really important because interoperability will be there. Also, you can share messages, and they have made many improvements over the messages. So let's say you got some photographs in a messages, you will be able to see them more clearly and you will be able to manage them. So you can send photo collections, you can flip through them easily. So it will be placed on a stack. So let's say these are the photographs, 6 photographs, they will be placed over the stack. So view them as a grid, you can view them as a grid, reply with quick tap back and save them to your library. So it will give you more fluidity in navigation. Also, you can share many things in Photos, Safari, Apple News, Apple Podcast and Apple TV app. You can easily find shared content and see who recommended it and reply right from the app you are enjoying it in without going back to messages. So the thing is that you don't have to open a separate message app while doing some work, while browsing or while being on call. You will be able to respond to your messages at the same time. So this is going to be really easy. You don't have to switch between apps. Designed to help your workflow. So basically your workflow should not be impacted. So Apple Safari is their browser and it works really fine, but I on the other hand prefer to use Google Chrome. I have my reasons, but Apple Safari is nonetheless very great and they have improved it. So they have their streamlined tab bar. So now you will be able to view their tabs easily, and it will take less space on the page and takes on the color of the site you are on. So it will extend the web page to the edge of the window and it will be like floating tabs. So it will give you a very good experience. You will be able to explore more quickly and you won't have any distractions. And you can also put your tabs in a group. So basically you can create number of tabs and put it into groups. So you will be able to share them and able to access them. So it will save and organize your tabs in the way that works best for you. So you can name your tab groups, you can edit them, switch between them as you go from one interest to the next. So you will be more sorted out. Also, they have some access tab groups anywhere. So be it on MacBook Air, MacBook Pro, Mac OS, iMac, you are working on iPad, you are working on iPhone, everywhere you will be able to access your tabs while on Safari. So it is going to be really cool feature because you won't have to find your single device if you want to access your tabs. And also they have focus. So nowadays we find many distractions and we don't want that. So you just focus, select focus from that notification. So let's say you are doing some coding or office stuff. So while doing that work, nobody will be disturbing you. So you will be working without having any kind of distraction. So this is going to be really easy for you guys, and hopefully it will bring very much relief to those people who are always getting annoyed by the notifications and they always have to distracted when they are doing some creative stuff or doing some important stuff. Now you can also signal your status. So basically when you are busy, you can give status to someone, so your status will be automatically displayed in messages. So it will be allowed to some other people who are messaging you that you are doing certain work. So basically you won't have to worry about that. The focus will take care of your all busyness and all your work, and they will get notification to your friends across all devices. As usual, you can use it on all devices. You can also take quick notes. So basically if you are using an iPad or using a MacBook OS, so you will be able to create your notes on the go, and it will be more flawless like before, and they have improved it a lot. So taking notes will be very easy, and you can also do many activities and mentions. So they have the new activity view, lets you see what others have added to your shared note. So these are the features of note. You can also use tags. This is going to be already a cool feature because tags are really useful now. Instagram, Twitter, and many websites are using this. Even YouTube, there are a lot of tags, so it becomes very easy for you. So they have many features, but the most important feature of the day of the video is universal control. So let's assume you are using three devices and you want to use a single control device. So basically let's say you are using one mouse, and you can use one mouse to control all three devices. You can also put your files seamlessly. So let's say you have three monitors adjacent to each other. Just pick one touchpad or trackpad, or just pick one mouse, and you will be able to access all the three screens at the same time. So you don't have to connect individually to any devices. You can transfer and share data very easily. So it will even connect to more than one Mac or iPad. So just move your cursor from your Mac to your iPad, type on your Mac and watch the words show up on your iPad, or even drag and drop content from one Mac to another. So this is going to be the most important feature of Mac OS, because it will definitely change the way you work, and it will give your workflow so much convenience that you will be able to complete a lot of stuff on very less time. So you will get more time to focus on other stuff, and you won't have to worry about just transferring your files from one device to another. You'll have to take the access from the same time. So this is going to be the most important feature. So you don't have to be any setup. So just put your devices next to each other and move your cursor seamlessly between them. So this is most important stuff. You don't need any setup, special setup for that. Just use it like you would everywhere, and it supports multiple devices and combinations. And also it has AirPlay to Mac, so now you can use AirPlay. So whatever is your iPhone will be on the screen, and you will be able to use Mac speakers while using your phone. So it will give you more convenience. Also they have superpowers for getting things done, like live text. So these are certain features which we may not be able to use as of now, but when they do, it will become very easy. So just like Google Lens, they have live text in photos. So basically you are taking any photo, and let's say there are some text, so you just have to select that text and you will get all the information. So let's say you just click this picture, so there are text. You can actually copy from clipboard, use it. You can also search it right there. So it will give you a lot of information when you are traveling and outside this country. So it will give you a lot of seamless experience, and these are the features which will make our lives much easier. There are many shortcut apps, so many things like share with a click, make your own, find the perfect shortcut. So these are the features which will be explained when the Mac OS will be released. So I will be able to explain more easily when they actually release on the PC. So they also have Apple Maps. So it will give you many features like 3D features. They are more intuitive, more rich, content rich. So it will look much easier for you to access. And it will also have transit feature. It will also have interactive globe. So just have to select the entire, just like Google Earth, you can discover the natural beauty of Earth, which is rich and interactive globe. So just use the globe and you will access everything. So it is going to be really easy. Now the last feature of our video is privacy. So Apple considers privacy their utmost importance, and they know that you get greater visibility into how and when apps access your mic and keep senders from learning about your activity in mail. So basically it will update you on time to time, and it will also show you recording indicator. So on control center, it will let you find out which apps have access to your mic, and you will see the new indicator on your screen whenever an app is accessing your microphone. So you will be able to know whenever you are being listened, and you will get your privacy settings over the mail. So they will send you email and they will let you know what are the privacy settings. So you will be able to know that your privacy still matters. And they also have iCloud Plus. So it is just like their cloud storage. You can put your videos, your mails and your important documents over the cloud. So this will have some new features like iCloud Private Relay, hide my email. So you can also hide your email address. If you don't want others to see your email address, you can also do that. And they have an expanded HomeKit secure video support. So HomeKit is a software where you can use your home devices and use at the same time. So I will explain it in later part of the video. So there are many features, and a lot of features will be rolling out soon enough. So it will also support AirPod audio. It will also have low power mode, so it will extend your battery life. So it will manage energy intensive apps and processing, and it directs power where you need it and get most out of your battery. So since the rolling out of their M1 chip, Apple Silicon, battery performance has improved a lot. So I really hope that they will be more easily battery accessibility for you guys, and you will be able to use your battery more conveniently and more precisely. So everything, every charge of the battery will be used, and you will get many things like system-wide translation, and there are many features. So that's it now, guys. So I guess this is where we are at the end of the video. These are the Macs which will be supported. So you will even get support from early 2015 and later. So this is the beauty of Apple. They don't leave their old devices like Android does. So whenever you purchase any Apple device, you are good to go for the next 4 to 5 years. You will get all the new features. So this is going to be more important stuff, because it will not only increase your device's life, but also it will give you utility that in the near future you can give your Apple devices to your loved ones. Just like your younger sibling who happens to visit somewhere else, you can also gift them your device, and you can buy yourself a new device and it will work fine. So you don't have to purchase a new device, because Apple support very good their old devices. And this is what we expect from Android. But I don't know, even OnePlus phones only support 2 years of software update. So let's hope they also learn from Apple and they also support their devices long enough so that the user will get everything out of their hardware. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I tried to explain everything in detail, and in the near time I will be making a dedicated video with mics and sound system and video camera. So I am working on it. I am making my studio. So in the near time you will see the videos more precise, concise and more, what you say, on the point. So I really hope you enjoyed this video. Please share your love by subscribing to my channel, and also like my other videos and share it with your friends and families. Also comment below what suggestion you have and what improvement should I make, and what other topics you want me to make videos. That's it for now, guys. Thanks for staying on my video. I will see you next time. Bye.